22 laps of action coming up here. Hold on to your hats. Jerez is underway. Good start there from Suzuki. Second on the grid. Not so good for Celestino Fietti. I'm not sure Dalla Porta's got away so well either. And it is going to be Suzuki that takes the whole shot from Dennis Foggia. And then it is Fietti who goes in just behind.
Oh, somebody was out of the seat there. Giammamassi had a real poor start. He had a big wheelie right off the line. Horror start for the co-world championship leader. Suzuki already about half a second clear on this very first lap. And Antonelli has made it. A 6.58 Squadra Corsa 1-2. Ruthlessly up the inside of Vietti. We've got a four further down the field. It's Rodrigo.
Rodrigo's gone down. Unbelievable. Maverick Vinales was hoping that he would be able to do something. He might be able to rejoin, but it will be no victory for Gabriel Rodrigo here today in Spain.
Yeah, you can see he was really angry. Was he pushed and shoved or was it all self-inflicted? We'll wait to see the replay. No drama so far for the 6.58 Squadra Corsa team. Suzuki still leads away.
Tatsuki Suzuki leading then and doing a good job out front. 46.7 for him. There is Aaron Canet, Foggia out wide there. That wide sweeping line we see so often from the experienced Italian Fanati.
Fastest lap of the racing so far, Steve, set by John McPhee. As you mentioned, he has gone for that Dunlop soft rear tyre. This is the stage of the race where that will be working perfectly. There's confirmation on your screens then. Louis McPhee on the charge. He's got up to ninth place already. McPhee gained four, five places in those first two laps.
Oh dear. That's the championship leader, Massia. He's down. There's a stretcher here. He looks hurt as well. Is that a high side then for Giammamassia? It's a crash at turn two. Here he is then in the slipstream of Callahan. That's what he's known as to his team, and he's straight through, neatly done that. He's given it a couple of laps just to warm into this one. Not a great start for Dalla Porta, but he's recovered well. He now leads this Spanish Grand Prix.
Just lined that up beautifully. Got the perfect exit, the perfect drive out of turn five on that back straight, and an effortlessly using the slipstream just to fire on through Tatsuki Suzuki. So it's Dalla Porta, the pole man from Suzuki, who was second on the grid behind him. And Antonelli connect. Vietti still right in there as well. So is Foggia. Ramirez, John McPhee continues his charge. He's not down into eighth place.
Yeah, there's a group of 10 here just starting to break away from the rest.
It's a favoured overtaking point at the end of this back straight into the Pedrosa corner. Now Vietti is looking up the inside and he's made it. He's got the job done. Dalla Porta's out a little bit wide and that allows Antonelli to come through as well.
Aggressive group this here at the front. And if they continue to chop and change, more will join. On board now with Dalla Porta, who's dropped to third, trying to challenge again on Tatsuki Suzuki and makes it stick. Nicely done. Just got to try and now get into the slipstream, but Canet here is ready to pounce. He's now getting into the slipstream, and Romano Fanati is very much in the game. Number 55, look out for him. Breaking down into that turn six, though. Look at Fanati, man.
God.
Around the outside of two riders.
He loves that round the outside move as well, I've got to say. Is that Andrea Migno?
Looked like
one of the Samakatar bikes was out wide at the Pedrosa corner. It was a brilliant move as well by Kinect to get up the inside of Dalla Porta. Was it briefly? Yeah, it was. Classic block pass there. Now, Romano Fanati thought he was going to try and hit the front. It is Suzuki. Instant revenge coming from Dalla Porta on Aaron Kinect. That was beautifully done in Piango on the Eto corner at turn number nine. You can't take your eyes off this one.
Around the two fast right-handers then here, turns 11 and 12. Romano Fanati ready to pounce on his VNA sniper's machine and up the inside he goes. As neat as that, but he can't quite hold it together and almost throws it away.
He was nearly down there. He was nearly on the floor. The front end almost cried no more. Brilliant save that by Fanati. Yeah, there you go, Dennis Foggia, the first track limits warning. Now, he's got to be careful. I've seen Foggia a couple of times run wide through turn number four in particular. Now, if he carries on doing that, he's going to be in trouble and he'll have to come through that long lap penalty lane at turn 13. He'll see that message on his dashboard, he'll know that race direction and made that communication with him. Of course, exceeding track limits proved so costly and decisive in this race here last year, Steve, didn't it? Alonso Lopez thought he got a dream home podium in front of his home crowd and repeated exceeding the track limits. Meant he was dropped back one place. Marcos Ramirez went on the podium again. Fanati tries to go round the outside of Dalla Porta through the Cito Fonts corner. Brilliant stuff by Bernardi.
Yeah, just look at him on the brakes when we come down into turn six here as Celestino Vietti, however, manages to squeeze past. Good move from him. Canet's up the inside of him, though. He goes back into third.
Cornfile got in hot. I think he had to just pick it up there, Cornfile, before he tagged the back of Dennis Foggia. Cost him a couple of places. A shame for Andrea Migno that he made that mistake in the Pedrosa corner a couple of laps ago. Migno had just set his fastest lap of the race, was starting to come on song, get into his rhythm and threaten the top six, but it dropped him way back down to 18th place. He lost a couple of seconds with that mistake, Migno.
Here comes Scalaporta again into turn five. Beautifully done. Can he hold the line? He can, but he's going to get mired again in a moment on the slipstream here on the back straight. Watch out for Canet, Demon on the brakes, and straight away, look at the slipstream here, the damage done to Lorenzo Dalla Porta. They're bucking, they're weaving, trying to find a way through, and here comes Canet. No, he'll stay second, but it is Suzuki that leads.
Well, all this jostling, the two fastest men on the track last time around, the only two in the 146s were Andrea Migno and Ayo Gura, as Philip Salat, who unfortunately had to retire from this race. Foggia's got to go in that long lap penalty. Well, he can't say he wasn't warned. He was messaged by race direction. He got the pit board from the team as well. So Dennis Foggia can kiss goodbye to his podium.
Oh, Vietti! Wow. Oh, my goodness me. How on earth has he stayed on board there? Antonelli's trying to go through on the inside, but he was on the grass fully there.
Well, that's grass cutting at 220 kilometres an hour from Celestino Vietti. Not what you're going to be doing. Heart in the mouth. He never even backed out of it.
That's the impressive thing, isn't it? They're so brave, these youngsters. Vietti there, heart in that moment on the way to Danny Pedrosa's corner.
He's called a few daisies, but thankfully nothing more than that.
Into turn number nine, now 10. Marcos Ramirez leads his home Grand Prix from Nico Antonelli. And then Dalla Porta, Vietti fourth, Suzuki fifth, Paul Farr in sixth.
So Foggia then knows he's got to come into this long lap penalty lane right here at turn 13. Is he going to do it this time around? No, he's not. He doesn't have to do it immediately, of course. He will have time.
Long lap penalty then, the notice given to Dennis De Menis. And that is a menace for him. And the next lap, he's going to have to take that. It is Antonelli that leads. Vietti again, nice on the brakes into turn one. He goes past fellow Italian Lorenzo Dalla Porta.
Qatar 2016, the last time Antonelli won a Grand Prix. A long, long time ago when he just pit Brad Binder to the finish line. A classic start to the 2016 Moto3 campaign. But straight away, he's going to take out a couple of bike lengths.
Oh, what's happened? Ramirez, that's dangerous. That's awful. The bike's gone out in the middle of the circuit as well.
He obviously hit Antonelli. Just couldn't quite see it. I'm pretty sure he just clipped the back of Antonelli. Fenati's been caught in that mayhem as well. Fenati's had to run on. Poor old Ramirez. What a massive, massive moment in this Spanish Moto3 Grand Prix as Dalla Porta somehow pulls it up on the brake. Oh, there's a collision further back.
Garcia. And one of the Samakatar Global machines as well. Is that Arenas or is it Fernandez?
It's Fernandez. I think it's Fernandez. Yeah, it's the Red Bull helmet. That's Fernandez. So Fernandez and Sergio Garcia. How many times have we seen collisions late on in Moto3 down at the Pedrosa corner?
One lap to go here in Jerez. It is Antonelli that leads across the line, and he might just about lead into turn one, but it's really tight there. Suzuki just going underneath Canet. Is that costly? There's contact there between Canet and Dalla Porta as well.
And somehow Cornfile's in third. Last lap, and there's going to be some fireworks. There's going to be some drama always. Is bulging and barging towards the back of this lead group. Katatova has had a track limits warning. Now all that pushing and shoving behind Antonelli. Sorry, Suzuki and Vierge. Vietti. I'm getting a bit carried away with the excitement. I'm even the wrong class. It is Nicolo Antonelli and Vietti. Oh, Italy versus Italy.
Oh, big moment at the front end there for Nico Antonelli. Now coming up alongside him, fellow Italian Celestino Vietti on his Humphreys first ever victory. Here comes Cornfile as well. He's in third. Can they get close enough? No, Cornfile's gone way too hot.
Way wide. Antonelli was in hot as well. You could see his Honda was making all kinds of weird and wonderful shapes. He tried to hold off Vietti. He has held off Vietti as they come into the stadium section then for the final time. Nicolo Antonelli hasn't won since Qatar 2016. Celestino Vietti has never won a Grand Prix, nor has the man in third place, Tatsuki Suzuki.
Suzuki with a lovely move there to make it a 1-2 for the team. Can he get close enough now to Antonelli?
Antonelli's got a pretty decent buffer here, Steve. He might well have this one covered. He might not be leaving himself open to attack at the final corner. Antonelli's ridden this third sector quite brilliantly. Cornfile was out of the seat coming through those right-handers. Surely nobody's close enough to Nicolo Antonelli. He's ridden the perfect final lap.
There can't be a desperate lunge. Defensive line there from Tatsuki Suzuki. The checkered flag is out. And finally, he returns to the top step. Nicolo Antonelli has won again. At last, across the line he goes. And it's a 1-2 for the SIG 58 Squadron Course Honda team. What a result. Jubilation.
Awesome for that team, absolutely awesome. Antonelli Suzuki, Celestino Vietti, what a drama-filled race he had. He comes home for his second podium finish in Moto3. Canet misses out in fourth. What an unbelievable emotion. But the race-winning trophy will be handed over by local government dignitaries. Elias Benesayag has the honour of handing over the winner's trophy to 23-year-old Cattolica rider Nicolo Antonelli. His fourth Grand Prix victory, just his seventh podium in the Moto3 World Championship.